I'm Marcos, and as a co-founder and a board member of Reload Greece, I also call myself a reloader. So moving on, like, first of all, just to summarize here, yeah, Reload Greece is here to connect you, to connect everyone, and we're creating a community of no borders. So there is opportunity to, like, come and get the support from Reload Greece in order to help with your startup, and then we can connect you with either the Greek funds or Chrysanthos or Mr. Bonassos or anyone around the world. So moving on, we may not have yet like a Greek unicorn based in Greece, but we do have a smart city. So Mr. Papastergiou became a mayor of Trikala in 2014 with a zero budget for his like grand dream of creating a tech-savvy city. But like a month ago, he was actually featured in The Guardian as the mayor of Greece's first smart city. I'm sure you have all heard or listened in the news about like the self-driving buses of Trikala, but there are many more innovations that are going on in the city that are making the lives of the local citizens much easier. So we'll hear more from the Mr. Papastergiou himself, and then a panel discussion will follow, moderated by Professor Iacovidis, who will be joined by Dean Francisco Veloso, Ella Goldner, and the aforementioned Mr. Papastergiou and Iacovidis. So, Mr. Papastergiou, over to you.
Okay, now I suppose that it is working also. I just need a minute to open my laptop because I managed to turn it off a second ago. So, thanks a lot for calling me. First of all, I have to introduce Trikala because I suppose that you don't know our city. The city of Trikala is a rather small city in the center of Greece. It has about 82,000 inhabitants, but it is a very famous city because of its great musical tradition, about Greek Tsipouro, about many other stuff like that. I'd like also to thank Reload Greece for all the efforts it takes. It is more than necessary during these very tough and difficult moments for Greece, good words and initiatives like that to be spoken around the globe. As an electrical engineer, I'm not so sure if Greece needs just reload. I suppose it had to work. Okay, a smart city wants and a smart remote. Okay. So I was telling you that I'm not so sure if Greece needs reload, defragment, or needs format from the beginning. Meanwhile, in Trikala, the last 4 years, we tried to deal with the problems in a totally different manner, to see our city differently, to define disruptive solutions where the conventional ones have failed. So what is the difference between our city, the humble city of Trikala, to all the others? In my opinion, we are not doing so many great things, so many impressive things. We're just trying to do the obvious. Because, okay, it's still not working. Yes, one. We're trying just to do the obvious, but exactly the obvious ones and the rational are the ones that are missing from our country nowadays. We started with the municipality financials. We were obliged to take difficult and necessary measures, and so we started to arrange our debts and our loans. We avoided the flattened words, and we spoke with the words of honest and truth to our community. We decreased the debt of our municipality from 45 millions, almost the half. We didn't say that we took a scorched earth, you know. Okay, doesn't work. You know that in Greece, scorched earth is the most easy thing to say when we don't want to take responsibilities. I said that the former mayor was a great guy and he tried hard to put the municipality out of the crisis. We didn't blame the opposite political parties, not even the former mayor. It's my principle that I wouldn't do anything to my municipality that I wouldn't do to my company. Today, our municipality pays all the obligations to the suppliers of the city, to the suppliers of the municipality, and that's why we regained our trust to citizens and suppliers, and that was something extremely important for us. Let's talk about technology, now it worked. Definitely, it can help us, but it is not an end in itself. It is just the means and not the mission for us, because it can help us live safer, maybe happier, and for sure better. But in the last decade, huge amount of money were spent on information technologies in Greece, but the outcomes were not so, were rather disappointing. This happened because, in my feelings, we followed a wrong way. We adopted solutions that weren't capable for our needs. We went from the opposite side. For example, we installed the apps and then we were trying to find where they could apply it on. In Trikala, we applied and we followed an opposite proceed. We analyzed our needs and tried to find out the best solutions to resolve all these needs and problems. Solutions that can be seen to my slide. It is the control room of my municipality. But as I told you, it is not the point, because I do believe that Trikala is a smart city, not only because of the apps or the sensors. Besides, in Greek language, smart city has not a perfect image translation. Because a smart city in Greece should be a city which will not cause troubles to their citizens, will generate growth and prosperity. It can undertake initiatives, or at the same time, of course, with daily problems such as garbages, potholes, lighting, congestion, etc. But even all these things, the small ones, the usual ones, we decided to see them from a different point of view. For example, we set up the citizens' help desk. This is our app, and through which this help desk, which operates for 16 hours per day, we try to support the daily problems with online registration via app and web. It collects complaints, classifies them, assigns them to the appropriate organization unit of the municipality, and monitors their progress. Our staff also calls back to the citizens in order to validate that the problem was resolved, and also we are counting, because that's a problem in the public sector of Greece. We don't like to be counted as far as the results, the time and the satisfaction of the citizens. But again, I have to say that nowadays all these initiatives are not the important ones for Greek municipality. I don't believe that a modern Greek city is only a city with advanced technology. It must be a city that takes care beyond the pothole symptom, the symptom of lighting, garbages, etc. And it is a city that takes more initiatives for local growth, for retaining the young people to Greece, for new job creation, and that's why we are undertaking important projects. First of all, the Aesculapius project. Trikala has its grassroots back to the ancient Triki, the homeland of Aesculapius, the first doctor of the universe. Aesculapius based its medicine on herbs in the mountain of Kosiakas, maybe the mountain with the biggest number of herbs in Greece. With the support of the Stavros Niarchos Foundation, we help new farmers farm herbs. Fellow visitors to our trip is also the US Rutgers University and the American Farm School of Thessaloniki. One of our goals is to empower agriculture, to perform research and develop innovation in agri-food, and to attract trekking visitors to follow the footsteps of myth in our incredible beauty paths like the one you see behind. The opposite mountain, near the famous rocks of Meteors. Okay. This is the famous rocks of Meteors, where we discovered, studied, and certified the healing spring of Rizoma. It is the most rich Greek healing spring in hydrogen sulfide and the subject of well-being, natural supplements, and the tourism could be our next big bet. Only 8 years ago, tourism and Trikala were rather contradictory subjects. And now, the humble and small city of Trikala is based on a simple idea of the former mayor, the heart of winter tourism based and close to the Milo Phillips, the most beautiful and famous national Christmas theme park, which is built around an old mill of 1887. We raised the number of visitors from 200 in the beginning to 1,200,000 the last year. And we managed to do something even more important. With the Milo Phillips revenues, we shared more than 200 robotic kits to all the public schools of Trikala. We supplied with Arduino and Raspberry boards, and with Lego we do and Mindstorm kits. And at the same time, we trained the teachers to enable teaching educational robotics to our students. We defined new potentials for young people with simple and low-cost initiatives. And all above were not performed by a single man, me. No one alone can create a new era, probably not even a team, although I'm extremely proud of my team. It is the community that changes a city. It is a community that has to welcome the upcoming changes. It's a community that has to allow and so shines that it's ready to change. And Trikala proves that it is a community like that. It shows it with its love, for example, to sustainable mobility. Trikala are having an image just like Stockholm and Amsterdam as far as the bicycles. It proved it with the famous project of autonomous bus, a difficult, demanding, global testing project that was completely successful. Against all the expectations and the complaints that some lovers of stagnation performed, the project was the most successful driverless project of Europe, and was implemented not in a protective area, but in the center of the city, and that was the most difficult. The community proved also the need to change with the immigrants' management. We respected the immigrants' issue as a national issue, and we did just our duty, without exceptions. Today, 400 refugees are living in Trikala without causing a single problem. It showed it in the end with the anti-smoking campaign. You may wonder what I'm telling you. The smoking campaign, why? Because, as you know, in Greece, we are trying to prohibit indoor smoking for more than 150 years. In Trikala, that's the truth, yes. In Trikala, we managed to do what neither the Greek government nor the members of the parliament and the members of the government, the ministers, can even do in the Greek parliament, where they smoke, as you know. Today in Trikala, we don't smoke, and in the closed spaces. Trikala wants to change and proves it. But the critical question is, does Greece want to change? Does Greece want to enable local communities, innovate, grow, and liberate? I'm not so sure if the answer is yes. In Greece, we have set up too many red tapes that transformed the administration to a bureaucratic monster that prohibits any growth attempt. Our reluctance to decentralize, to escape from a state that wants to control everything, it is a huge obstacle for the growth of cities and municipalities. But we will keep on fighting because I must admit that we found the proper way during these years. We escaped from the physical boundaries out of the world, just like today, and showed what we can do. And we made our people feeling proud of their city, the city of Trikala. We didn't change the city, it is not a time for miracles, but we change the way the citizens view their city. We made them love their city again a little bit more and take care of it again. This is the most important change that we're trying to do in Trikala, to change our minds, just like Winston Churchill said to Darkest Hour, to change our mentality. And of course, we have a long way to go. But the first step was taken, the change began, and no one can do it alone. It has been driven by all the local community, for which, regardless the results of next elections, I will be always proud of. Thank you so much.